Guys, I'm going back to check this door again. After Sans talked about it last time, I figure it's about time we check it out. Also, I just thought of something. If it really takes a human soul and a monster soul, then why can't Asgore and I walk across together? Why is it that we can't work together on this? Do we have to kill each other? What is this about? It's a door, it's a door, it's a door. I don't care that it's a door. Where's Toriel?
Oh, hey! You're leaving soon, right? Don't come here to say goodbye! Goodbyes aren't allowed in my town. Just see you laters.
Hey, punk, what's up?
Papyrus, how can you stand this gold? I have no skin!
So why don't we go stand in Grobies instead?
Because I hate grease!
But you don't have a stomach!
No, but I have standards!
It's a wall of fame full of quotes and photos from visiting celebrities. The food is to die for, gorgeous style and fragrance. My face tastes beautiful. These were all from Minutun. It's a performance schedule. Comedians, dancers, Sans. Seems there's a break now. Ha! It's Sans and there's a break. Ha! I'm the resort. Yeah, I know that. Okay. You have to. Okay. Yeah, we've checked out all those things before. The thing is, I'm not seeing anything else. I have no idea what else there is to do. So I guess we're here. Welcome back, guys. I don't know what to say. Ring, ring, there's no response. Let's go say hello to Asgore. This is the longest ride yet. And I'm not sure I'm ready, honestly. Asgore doesn't seem like a terrible monster, but he can't let us go and we can't just let him go either. My question is this, why can't we leave together? If a human and a monster soul can come through, then why can't I just take the monsters with me if they really want to leave so badly? The castle elevator. Bizquick level 1. Oh. It's a city. It's a very large city that looks extremely similar to the one we saw at the beginning of the game. What did they call it? They called it Home? And this is the city of New Home. The city they built right next to the barrier. Since there wasn't enough room in the ruins. The elevator is in use. Someone else is using it? This is insane that the monsters could build all this. And now here I am walking all alone. Not a monster in sight. No. No. Okay, no, 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 no. No. Wait, wait. This cannot be just like Toriel's place. Toriel. Why is it just like Toriel's house? Why is it just like Toriel's house? The way is blocked by two padlocks. There's a note attached. Howdy, I'm in the garden. If you have anything you need to get off your chest, please don't hesitate to come. The keys are in the kitchen and the hallway. It's a golden flower. It's a golden flower. Unlike Toriel, this person's good at cultivating flowers. The coals are still warm. They are full photo albums, scrapbooks, books on how to make tea. Seems like gardening tools. It's a great reading chair, but it doesn't seem like anyone uses it. A long time ago, a human fell into the ruins. Injured by its fall, the human called out for help. The fridge is full of unopened containers of snails. There's some white fur stuck in the drain. It's a note. Howdy, help yourself to anything you want. You took the key and put it on your phone's keychain. The stovetop is very clean. Someone must use fire magic instead. It's a trash can. It's full of crumpled up recipes for butterscotch pie. Is this Toriel? Or Azriel, the king's son, heard the human's call. He brought the human back to the castle. Is this Toriel? Or is this Asgore? But wait, that's an Azriel? What was that? But that sounds like a lot like combinations of those. There's a heart-shaped lock inside the box. Will you take it? There's a worn dagger inside the box. I will never take that. Heart locket armor defense 15. It says best friends forever. What a comfortable bed. If you lay down here, you might not ever get up. The drawing of a golden flower. The family photograph. Everyone is smiling. There are lots of striped shirts in here. The twin-sized bed. Why are there two beds in here if there was only dusty toys? It's a golden flower. Room under renovations. This is sounding really familiar. Over time, Azriel and the human became like siblings. The king and queen treated the human child as their own. The underground was full of hope. Toriel and Asgore were the queen and king. Azriel, the prince, and that human like sibling to the prince. You took the key and put it on your phone's keychain. It's Asgore's journal. All the current pages says is nice day today. The ink is still almost wet. It's a king-sized bed. Macaroni art of a flower for King Dad. It's a bureau. There's a Santa Claus outfit inside. It's a clothes store. There are robes, button-up shirts, and a pink hand-knit sweater that says Mr. Dad Guy. It's a trophy. Number one nose nuzzle champs of 98. He even played Santa every year. It's just a chair. Despite everything, it's still you. I'm sure if you'd come back here, if you'd come to this point in the game, and if you had killed everyone, you would have been a monster at this point. And not one of the ones out there. The ones who work so hard. But one that eats away at everything, tears everything apart, just to better itself. You unlock the chain. There's an old calendar from the end of 201X. The date has circled on it. Then, one day, the human became very ill. The sick human had only one request, to see the flowers from their village. But there was nothing we could do. Oh no, Azrael, you didn't! The next day, the human died. Azrael, racked with grief, absorbed the human soul. He transformed into a being with incredible power. With the human soul, Azrael crossed through the barrier. He carried the human's body into the sunset, back to the village of the humans. You're kidding. Oh no! Oh no, is this what I think it is saying? Azrael reached the center of the village. There, he found a bed of golden flowers. He carried the human onto it. No. Oh, this is starting to make so much sense. Suddenly, screams rang out. The villagers saw Azrael holding the human's body. They thought that he had killed the child. The humans attacked him with everything they had. He was struck with blow after blow. Azrael had the power to destroy them all. But Azrael did not fight back. Clutching the human, Azrael smiled and walked away. Wounded, Azrael stumbled home. He entered the castle and collapsed. His dust spread across the garden. The kingdom fell into despair. The king and queen had lost 2 children in one night. The humans had once again taken everything from us. Not all of us did, though. The king decided it was time to end our suffering. Every human who falls down here must die. With enough souls, we can shatter the barrier forever. It's not long now. King Asgore will let us go. King Asgore will give us hope. King Asgore will save us. Toriel, but you didn't agree with this, right? You should be smiling, too. Aren't you excited? Aren't you happy? You're going to be free. There was no message. No anything. As I approach King Asgore, we're finally here. But that's not a Sans? Sans, no, you can't. Sans, I won't fight you.
So you finally made it. The end of your journey's at hand. In a few moments, you will meet the king. Together, you will determine the future of this world. That's then, now. You'll be judged. You'll be judged for your every action. You'll be judged for every experience you've earned. What's EXP? It's an acronym. It stands for Execution Points.
What the fuck?
A way of quantifying the pain you've inflicted on others. When you kill someone, your EXP increases. When you have an FEXP, your love increases. Love, too, is an acronym.
It stands for a level of violence. A way of measuring someone's capacity to hurt. The more you kill, the easier it becomes to distance yourself. The more you distance yourself, the less you will hurt. The more easily you can bring yourself to hurt others. But you never gained any love. Of course, that doesn't mean you're completely innocent or naive. Just that you kept a certain tenderness in your heart. No matter the struggles or hardships you faced, you strive to do the right thing. You refuse to hurt anyone. Even when they ran away, you did it with a smile. You never gained love, but you gained love. Does that make sense? Maybe not. Now, you're about to face the greatest challenge to your entire journey. Your actions here will determine the fate of the entire world. If you refuse to fight, Asgore will take your soul and destroy humanity. But if you kill Asgore and go home, monsters will remain trapped underground. What will you do? Well, if I were you, I would have thrown in the towel by now. But you didn't go that far by giving up, did you? That's right. You have something called determination. So as long as you hold on, so long as you do what's in your heart, I believe you can do the right thing. All right. We're all counting on you, kid. Good luck.
Wait, what? Sans? What the... How did Sans... I'm not ready. I'm not ready, but I'm doing it anyway. Let's do this, guys. We're gonna give it one shot. Without any of the cheap items that we normally use. The throne room. Throne entrance. And we don't get any messages either, sadly. What's down here? It's a coffin. There's a name engraved on it. Bisquick. It's empty. Oh. These are the souls. These are where they're keeping them. Alright. Well then. We do it now. Oreo, please pick up. Pyre Sundyne? Anyone? Let's do this, guys. These flowers that saved us so many times.
Dum-dee-dum. Oh, is someone there? Just a moment.
That voice. When I died. Last episode, that was your voice, telling me to fight on. Why would you tell me to fight on?
I have almost finished watering these flowers.
Okay, I'll wait. Here we are.
Howdy. How can I...
Oh.
I so badly want to say, would you like a cup of tea? But you know how it is.
You're so hurt.
Nice day today, huh? Birds are singing, flowers are blooming. Perfect weather for a game of catch.
I guess it is.
You know what we must do. When you're ready, come into the next room. It's a throne. And these flowers. These are the same flowers that saved us so many times. It's another throne covered by a white sheet. Toriel. I miss talking to you. And after seeing this sky, I can do nothing but think of you. How tense. This is... Just think of it like a visit to the dentist. This is just like where I first fell. Are you ready? If you're not, I understand. I am not ready either. The end. Okay, that's a cool effect. This is the barrier. This is what keeps us all trapped underground. If by chance you have any unfinished business, please do what you must. I guess we have to, right? Undyne and Papyrus, they're done. They say they don't want us to say goodbye. Just see you later. And that's what we'll do, right? We'll see them later. I see. This is it, then. Ready? A strange light fills the room. Twilight is shining through the barrier. It seems your journey is finally over. You're filled with determination. Human, it was nice to meet you. Goodbye.
Oh my god!
Did he just break my spare button? What the fuck? What? Asgore attack 80, defense 80. Okay, that's familiar. You quietly tell Asgore you don't want to fight him. His hands tremble for a moment. This is like a more threatening version of... You tell Asgore that you don't want to fight him. His breathing gets funny for a moment. You firmly tell Asgore to stop fighting. Recollection flashes in his eyes. Asgore's attack dropped. Asgore's defense dropped. Seems talking won't do any more good. Fine. And then for the first time, wait, the spider tone at your HP was maxed out. I don't know how to fight. I've never actually done this before. Thank you. Spider Cider. Okay, I understand. So they're orange because you have to keep moving, and the blue one you don't move. Okay, I get it. Dodged. High score. I don't want to fight you. And if I can, I will show you mercy. Apply the bandage, you recovered 14 HP. Sorry about the little cut there. Damage. I'm about to die. You drink the Star Fae, your HP is maxed out. Damage. Damage. You eat the Hush Puppy, your HP is maxed out. Seems talking won't do any good anymore. Has core. So that is how it is. I remember the day after my son died. The entire underground was devoid of hope. The future had once again been taken from us by the humans. In a fit of anger, I declared war. I said that I would destroy any human that came here. I would use their souls to become a godlike and free us from this terrible prison. Then I would destroy humanity and let monsters rule the surface in peace. Soon the people's hopes returned. My wife, however, became disgusted with my actions. She left this place never to be seen again, Toriel. Truthfully, I do not want power. I do not want to hurt anyone. I just wanted everyone to have hope. But I cannot take this any longer. I just want to see my wife. I just want to see my child. Please, young one, this war has gone on long enough. You have the power. Take my soul and leave this cursed place. I told you once, I'll tell you a million times. We should stop this. After everything I've done to hurt you, you would rather stay down here and suffer than live happily on the surface? Human, I promise you, for as long as you remain here, my wife and I will take care of you as best we can. We can sit in the living room, telling stories, eating butterscotch pie. We could be like a family. I thought so. Flowey! Flowey, you son of a- You idiot! You haven't learned a thing. In this world, it's kill or be killed. What? Close the game? Flowey, you... Ugh! Wait, what? What the heck?
It's me, Flowey. Flowey the Flower. I owe you a huge thanks. You really did a number on that old fool. Without you, I could never have gotten past him. But now, with your help, he's dead.
No, you didn't kill Toriel. You didn't kill I saw you kill Asgore, but I left Toriel.
And I've got the human souls. Boy, I've been empty for so long. It feels great to have a soul inside me again. I can feel them wriggling. Aw, you're feeling left out, aren't you? Well, that's just perfect. After all, I only have 6 souls. I still need one more. Before I become God. And then, with my newfound powers. Monsters. Humans. Everyone. I'll show them all the real meaning of this world. Oh, and forget that escaping your old save file. It's gone forever. But don't worry. Your old friend Flowey has worked out a replacement for you. I'll save over your own death. So you can watch me tear you to bloody pieces. Over and over and over. What? Do you really think you can stop me? You really are an idiot.
Sans, if you could help me here. Oh my god. Oh my god! It's hideous! Oh my... Get the fuck... Get the fuck... Ow! Ow! What the fuck? You called for help. Ow.
Different than everything in the game thus far.
You called for help. Two souls down. What? He's loading. He seems really upset with me. Okay. Oh, I just realized what all these are. The knives, the weapon you could use, these ballet shoes, those gloves, these are weapons.
You're never waking up.
Well, come on, you closed it again. Okay, I'm opening it right now.
Did you really think I was going to be satisfied killing you only one time?
Fight back against him.
This is such a bullet hell.
Ow!
These are finger- they're finger banging me!
Finally.
For help. Create kindness, life, calm. Files. Come on. Oh, come on. It's cheap as hell. More ready onto this part. Oh hey, the frying pan I've been using. You called for help.
Yay, donuts!
Hit me with that attack! Fight back!
God. Alright, on to this one. Is this the final one? Final human soul? Come on! Please. I need more help than that. I didn't even know you could get a gun! All these other humans out there who died to this? You guys are really filling with determination. Well, his defense dropped to zero. These humans want nothing from you. They don't want to help you. Why would they ever want to help you? I'm really bad at dodging these. A dodging piece. Can I? Well, if you're using the bombs, I can, because you missed the character. I'm filled with hope. With determination. What's wrong, Flowey? You starting to hurt a little bit?
No! This can't be happening!
I thought it was kill or be killed, huh? You!
Ah, son of a bit! You idiot!
I knew you were gonna have a third one.
What, you're gonna keep doing this forever?
Because you have to.
Did you really think you could defeat me? I'm the god of this world. And you? You're hopeless. Hopeless and alone. Golly, that's right. Your worthless friends can't save you now. Call for help, I dare you. Cry into the darkness. Mommy, daddy, somebody help. See what good it does you. You called for help. But nobody came. Boy, what a shame. Nobody else is gonna get to see you die.
Well, I know someone.
What? How do you... Well, I'll just... Where are my powers? Sorry. Souls? What are they doing?
I have friends.
No! No! You can't do that! You're supposed to obey me! Stop! Stop it! Stop!
After everything, you are truly a monster. But honestly,
I don't believe you. It's not kill or be killed. What are you doing? Do you really think I've learned anything from this? No. I don't care about you learning something.
It's not about you, Flowey. It's not all about you. It's about what I would become. The monster I would become. And honestly, that's not even a good term for it. Because the monsters I've met here, they weren't monsters. They were my friends. They were the kindest souls I had ever met. So no, monster isn't a good term. The thing I would become would be an abomination. And honestly, I never want to become that. Sparing me won't change anything. Killing me is the only way to end this. I don't care. If you let me live, I'll come back.
Then come at me, bro.
I'll kill you.
Better have tried.
I'll kill everyone.
If that's what you have to do.
I'll kill everyone you love.
Honestly, even if I did believe that, I'd be there and I'd defend them. Forever. And ever.
Why?
Because that's what we do, those who actually feel love.
Why are you being so nice to me?
Because, Flowey, it's not the type of person who I am to hurt someone.
I can't understand. I can't understand. I just can't understand.
Flowey ran away.
Ring, ring.
Hey, is anyone there? Well, just calling to say, you made a snowman really happy. Guess I should say something else, too. So, it's been a while. The queen returned and is now ruling over the underground. She's instated a new policy. All the humans who fall here will be treated not as enemies, but as friends. It's probably for the best, anyway. The human souls the king gathered seems to have disappeared. So, that plan ain't happening anytime soon. But even though people are heartbroken over the king, and things are looking grim for our freedom, the queen's trying her best not to let us give up hope. So, hey, if we're not giving up down here, don't give up wherever you are, okay? Who knows how long it'll take, but we will get out of here.
Sans, who are you talking to?
Oh, nobody.
What? Nobody? Can I talk to them too?
Here, knock yourself out.
Wait a second. I recognize this number. Attention, human. I, the Great Papyrus, am now captain of the Royal Guard. It's everything I've ever dreamed of. Except instead of fighting, we just water flowers. So that's ever so slightly different. We're helping Dr. Alphys with her research. She's gonna find a way to get us out of here. Undyne's helping her too. Though, to be honest, her method of helping seems kind of, explosion-inducing. But I think Alphys likes having her around. Oh!
Hey, what are you up to, punk? Nah?
Please don't noogie the phone!
Hey, who's in charge here?
me!
Oh, yeah, that's right. I quit my job as leader of the Royal Guard. Actually, since we won't be fighting anymore, the Royal Guard is totally disbanded. There's, only one member now.
But he's extremely good.
Yeah, he is. Come here.
Please don't nuggie the skeleton.
Anyways, now I'm working as Alphys' lab assistant. We're gonna find a way out of this dump once and for all.
I suggest, in the trash heap, there's actually a waterfall you can climb up. Go there.
Oh yeah, and I'm a gym teacher at the Queen's New School. Did you know I can bench press 7 children?
What?
Awesome, right? Hey, I'm sorry about what happened with Asgore. You were just doing what you had to. It's not your fault he... darn it. I missed the big guy. Come on, Undyne, snap out of it. I guess I'll tell you how Alphys is doing. Well, she's the same as ever. Maybe a little more reclusive than normal. Seems like something's really bothering her. But she can get through it. I'm there supporting her. That's what friends are for, right? Hey, wherever you are, I hope it's better than here. It took a lot of sacrifice to get you there. So wherever you are, you have to try to be happy, okay? For our sakes. We'll feel better knowing our trouble is worth it. We're all with you. Everyone is, even the Queen. Hey, wait a second. Toriel, do you wanna... Heh, she says she's busy.
But if she knew who we were talking to...
We wouldn't get the phone back for at least a few hours.
We have mercy to spare you from her.
But call back any time, okay? She'd love to talk. Oh, whoops. This thing's almost out of batteries. So, hate to cut this short, but... Be seeing you, okay, buddy?
Bye-bye for now.
See ya, punk.
Click.
Why? Why did he let me go? Don't you realize that being nice just makes you get hurt? Look at yourself. You made all these great friends, but now you'll probably never see them again. Not to mention how much they've been set back by you. Hurts, doesn't it? If you'd just gone through without caring about anyone, you would have to feel bad now. So I don't get it. If you really did everything the right way, why did things still end up like this? Why? Is life really that unfair? Say, what if I told you I knew some way to get you a better ending? You'll have to load your save file and, well, in the meantime, why don't you go see Dr. Alphys? It seems like you could have been better friends. Who knows, maybe she's got the key to your happiness. See you soon.